we are in fact the world's smallest large company. You know, for a company of our, if you will, scale, the company is really only 38,000 people large. So we're actually very, very small. We're about 1/8 the size of Microsoft. One of my favorite things now is I'm looking for a new restaurant. I describe all the things and I tell it, read reviews, read PDFs, go read web pages. And it goes off and reads like 200 different sources and it comes back and tells me which is the best tonkatsu restaurant. Champagne. I hope it's really strong champagne.
It's
thanks, Rev. This is all I get. All right, good. Not the alcohol part. I'm super thirsty. All right, so welcome to NVIDIA. Today, once a quarter, my management team gets together for what we call an e-staff face-to-face. Okay, because half of my management team is in Israel, and half of them here, and so we really don't get to see each other face to face except about once a quarter. I have 60 people on my direct staff, and so imagine it's more than this room. Okay, about this room. Is there about 60 people here?
80
more. 80. Okay, all right. Okay, 80 guests. That's fantastic.
We're all willing to get hired.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, you know, you say that now, and then as soon as you join one of our e-staff face-to-face, you go, I don't want to be here. Today, most people are working from home, but Tuesdays and Thursdays, almost everybody comes to work. And the reason for that is because Tuesdays and Wednesdays, happy hours. And so because there's a direct correlation between attendance and happy hour. I think we have happy hour, should have happy hour every day. As all of you know, one of the most important instruments of society is the computer. It is the fabric of society. In fact, it's part of our social infrastructure now. Just as we have water, electricity, roads, education, computing is part of the infrastructure. And the extension of the computer, for example, the internet is part of a social infrastructure. Over the last 30 years, we've been working on a new way of doing computing, we call it accelerated computing. And now, this way of computing has reinvented how everything is done. We used to do software by human coding, hand coding, and we run it on compilers and run the results of it on CPUs. Now we don't use hand coding only, we now use machine learning. We let the machine, let the computer go figure out how to detect patterns and how to learn the essence and the, what we call feature learning, learn the if you will, the language of the data. And so now we've learned the language of numbers and learned the language of images and video and sound and letters and any language and proteins and chemicals. We've now learned the language of almost anything you can digitize. And so now machine learning has completely reinvented computing, and the processor that is best for it is NVIDIA GPUs, and that's the reason why we're here. Now the application that sits on top of this method called machine learning is something we talk about every day. It's called artificial intelligence. Now the computer no longer requires programming by us writing instructions very precisely. The way you program a computer is tell the computer what you like. So we're now all programmers, isn't that right? You could tell the computer what you desire, and it would systematically understand what you mean, break it down step by step, reason about how best to solve it, maybe even go use tools, reach out to other AIs, and systematically solve the problem for you. One of my favorite applications now is this application called Deep Research. And you know, I was saying that, well, Deep Research, you tell it what you want and it goes off, not just does a search, but it goes and reads papers and websites and PDFs and might even watch a video and listen to a podcast, comes back and learns from it, reasons about what it learned, and applies that knowledge to help you solve a problem, right? And so one of my favorite things now is I'm looking for a new restaurant. I describe all the things, and I tell it, read reviews, read customer reviews, read PDFs, go read web pages, and it goes off and reads like 200 different sources, and it comes back and tells me which is the best tonkatsu restaurant. And writes me a nice review, and you know, sorts it and highlights the different characteristics of each restaurant and their benefits and their disbenefits and what people say about it. Really fantastic. And when it comes back, it's now an expert on tonkatsu. It didn't just come back with the information, it came back with intelligence. And so now you could ask it all kinds of questions about tonkatsu. Pretty amazing.
Fantastic.
Pretty fantastic. Because it learned from all these different websites, now it's an expert on tonkatsu. I'm pretty certain that the next generation, the children that are growing up, by the time that they, of course, grow up, they won't understand a world where computers, you have to go click and, you know, search. You'll just talk to the computers. And so that future of computers that can actually even predict what you are even going to ask, understand exactly what you mean when you do ask, and can work in the background while you go off and do something else. You know, that future world where you have autonomous AI systems working on your behalf, watching out for you, you know, taking care of things before you even realize you have a desire. Those kind of systems are going to come in the near future. Okay, so this is the headquarters of all of that that's happening.
Yeah. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Great. Thank you.
So that kind of gives you a sense of it.
Okay. So, yeah. Have a fresh breath.
Hey, thank you.
Whoa. No, this is warm.
Okay.
You all right.
Fresh breath. All right. That's so sweet.
Thank you. You know, just so you know, I was a busboy, so the warmth doesn't matter. Tomorrow morning, it'll still be good.